Hi, my name is David from the University of the Witwatersrand in Johannesburg. I'm delighted for this opportunity to present Stellar PGX, an XFlow pipeline that we developed for calling star alleles in cytochrome P450 genes. Cytochrome P450 enzymes metabolize over 80% of commonly prescribed medications. Now, we know that genetic variation influences how different individuals respond to medications. Therefore, accurately genotyping CYP genes is very important for personalized medicine, as it would promote reliable metabolizer phenotype prediction in clinical and research settings. CYP genes are known to harbor a lot of genetic variations, and these are phased into haplotypes commonly known as star alleles. These star alleles could also include structure variations, which are challenging to interrogate bioinformatically. As an example, here we see the cytochrome 2D6 gene locus on chromosome 22. So CYP2D6 is located alongside two pseudogenes, CYP2D7 and CYP2D8. There is a 94% homology between CYP2D7 and CYP2D6, and this causes a number of challenges in sequencing and also bioinformatics data analysis, especially when using short-read data. So this is especially true, especially when an individual has one of these complex structure variations, because then the reads from CYP2D6 could easily misalign to CYP2D7 and vice versa. For example, here where you have these hybrid gene copies and also these tandem rearrangements. Additionally, for example, here in C where we have the gene duplication alleles, so it can be challenging to infer which of the gene copies is actually duplicated, and this has implications for the phenotype prediction. So looking at some of these challenges, it motivated us to develop a reproducible pipeline, Stellar PGX, for calling star alleles in cytochrome P450 genes such as CYP2D6. What is unique about Stellar PGX is that it employs graph-based variant detection in the beginning, and then also uses combinatorial star allele detection downstream. So just talk about the graph-based variant detection. So we know that most of the time variant calling is based on using a linear reference genome. However, in Stellar PGX, we use a tool called GraphTyper, which uses known variants and augments them to the reference genome to form a graph structure, and then realigns the reads to that graph structure. And by doing that, it improves the read alignment quality and also the variant calling confidence. But however, accurately detecting the variants is just halfway the journey. We still need to phase those variants into haplotypes and then also infer the diplotypes. So here we use, instead of a statistical phasing approach, we built a database from based on the Pharmacogene Variation Consortium catalogs, and so with that database we are able to use a combinatorial approach to phase the different variants, and also we also use the depth of coverage to determine the structure of a variation in a sample. And I'm happy to go into detail in this. You can contact me anytime during the conference or even afterwards, so that if you're interested, you can chat more about the methodology. But one other important thing I want to mention about Stellar PGX is that it is containerized using Docker and Singularity and implemented in Nextflow. Which makes it highly reproducible and easy to install, and very happy to chat more about this during the conference. Thank you. And I would like to acknowledge my collaborators, funders, and data providers.